question that could give rise to the doctrine of transcription. I think transcription is an appropriate topic to discuss at a TEDx talk. We find the teaching cover precisely because it contains students. Now, don't get me wrong, there's no big difference of facts and hard science, but if it's more to me about how to form either type of science, if you want to know how to make artificial intelligence, science can answer that. But if you want to have a discussion about the possible ramifications of color, fixing can play a role in that decision. Or if, in what way would artificial intelligence enslave mankind to take over the world? And you notice that outcome is taken for granted in sci-fi. Although, I do think the Terminator got that vision a little bit wrong. But the enslavement of mankind was a thing of this. We are eager participants. But time travel science fiction in particular, some of the changes that it could raise discussion about are perhaps cause and effect. Free will and maybe possible incompatibilities between those two, resulting in paradoxes. And different fictions have dealt with this in different ways. Experienced fading photographs to show the ramifications on the present, but get bigger response to a whole disaster. There is an episode of Doctor Who where there's a paradox on the use of the TARDIS is capable of traveling through time and space. Powerful enough to hold the paradox in limbo. Or in quantum leap, they avoided the possibility of paradoxes by having the main character travel not to his own house but to an alternate reality. Of course, there's any number of cases where this time traveler accidentally created the reality which we could avoid in the first place. But one summer I was working in a media labor job, lots of time spent, and got to wonder, what if we tried to avoid artistic license? Would the actual laws of physics avoid a paradox already? Because what I can resolve largely around the speed of light, which is evidence the fastest that we can go, but there are a couple of nuances to this reason that are less workable. The first is that it challenges movement through space time, not just space. And I'll elaborate on the second is that it applies not only to rockets, but to information. And before we tackle space-time, imagine a car driving along the highway, set of noise, and then there's a bend in the road, and it's not northeast. So its eastward velocity is increased, but at the expense that the northward velocity has to decrease. The space-time equivalent of that is what is responsible for the space-time paradox. This is when one twin gets on a rocket, zooms around the universe, and comes back, and hasn't aged as much as the one that stayed home. The motion causes the rate of time to alter. So now let's imagine a graphic where time is on the vertical axis, and space the distance on the horizontal, and we can think about it as part of the cover, which is not moving any specific distance in space, but is moving forward through time and distance by an amount we'll represent as zero with a length of c. Now, moving cover is traveling through both distance and time, and so that same area with a length of c has to go less through time in order to go more through space. You see, that's the trade-off, and the occupants of the red color will have an age less than the ones in blue. As for the season of the planet in its formation, I'll start by explaining the classic way of trying to beat the speed limit. We could start by imagining a light years with the rotating beam. And suppose a boat wanted to drive around in a circle and keep up with the rotation of that beam. So it was close to the land, which is the next small circle, is a better chance of being able to do this, but farther the boat is from the lighthouse, the faster it's going to go to the center of the circle. Well, now to the basic point again. We maintain this in terms of individual photons leaving the laser pointer and spreading them. And the spot they project does something for the energy that's in light. We even have a race between the red laser pointer that is part of the system and mine. But they need to say, go. Of course, the red laser pointer is not listed in light. If you want to be beaten. But before we start celebrating our fun, the speed limit applies to information. We need to see the information for ourselves. Someone at B wants to know how many cookies do you have? They keep this out. Person at Earth has 5. Person at B has 7. They're going to reply by encoding those numbers into the photons that they want to message to be sent. But all the green cookies say 5. The gets to be is via the very last photon because we break them only to the focus of light. Nothing actually moves information from A to B other than the red photon. Nothing is going to change the density of light here. Nothing is actually information. Or maybe to put it another way, nothing the green laser pointer can do could ever move the 7. Imagine the timeline is like a Dutch history book, and the time travel goes back to an earlier chapter and starts rewriting it in overtime. Meanwhile, new chapters of writing the book are being written, but the author writing it has no idea that the earlier chapters don't say what we remember them being said. So, if we take those as the rules of time travel, at least for this talk, then what could we do with that? What are the tools that we're going to do? Let's keep it a little bit more deep. How about we take a footage test down? Great. You just got a new job, you have to move from Washington, D.C. to San Francisco. You'll make a road trip out of it, but there's so many cool states to go visit. What route are you going to take? You only take one, and so and you settle on the subway bridge. But as you're unpacking, so you take out your home phone and send a text back to your earlier self. And so earlier self takes the hard overwriting this one. But of course, it can never catch up to you because you're the same person. You have all the same names, you can hear all the same memories. But you need that part of this one to work. It's if you're a voice system, some version of that one. You want to receive the message that the decision, take the simple way out. You do whatever your cell phone tells you to do. You're in some way. You have freedom. Face it just like a change can never catch up to the present. A change can also never catch up to another change. The little blue island of dots, it's 16 letters long, and it will stay 16 letters long. That this is what you think about is what's if every letter has possibility to be different and containing a different story, different history from the letter right next to you. You can have it. Harry Potter can spell it just a single letter right, and then the letter right behind it spells out one of the writings, and it just moves through as a writing object. What would this real life report look like? Smallest version of the state of the world. And there's a scientific equivalent of the concept. I use it better as it's my analogy, but we can use the smallest unit of time that can take a physics as a clock count, 10 to the negative 45 seconds. The conclusion I draw from that is that every one of those 10 units could be a separate copy of history. There would be limitless copies of help us for that. Now that we have some remembering that wants to know that. So now if we could solve this for us, that's so cool. Let's go back in time. I've got to have an Einstein call. Bring him to the present. But now it's going to be one Einstein call. Two more Einsteins. And as you're working your way through this, some administrator walks into your office and says, what's in the whole thing? Can all I do is draw one whole set of the 9 seconds. It's kind of for 10 seconds only. It's more than the population of Earth. Data is large enough, so they can be hard to imagine. And as this is trivial for me, the entire population of the Earth corresponds with the range of the city limits of Phoenix, which hold the range of space. And as a mixer, as a comparison, well, scale models. Imagine where this is the size of the people. It's sitting on the sidewalk outside the window. That would make the sun the size of this cupboard. It would be at the main entrance of campus. Pluto would be some little speck located just past the downtown courthouse. As it was orbit, something like Prescott would cover the entire city for the combined miles. So, 244 Einsteins versus a 10 million city inside of Phoenix. Well, the Einsteins would be this big. Let me clarify, if you're not saying everyone is close to the Phoenix and can afford 45 cents to cover 45 states, you're saying if the Earth were the size of a canyon, that's how many Earths you would need to make next to all the Einsteins. It would outweigh the Milky Way by factor of 1,000. It would literally destroy our galaxy and all the neighboring galaxies from 1 second to the first one. And I dwell on the enormity of this number to raise a philosophical question. If there were that many copies of every second of you in every second of history, if we had an abundance ad absurdum, what would still be valuable? The answer. I'm not suggesting the answer to that matter, but I think it's a question. We could just go back 10 years and get a microsecond's worth of history and have unlimited data forever. We could even pump all the pollution back 10 years ago and not have to worry about it back. Because if people look at the time, I object, but we're the ones with the time travel technology, not them, so we do that, we're towards the past selves. It's a different dimension of our existence. We already take this small area of the land, totally ruined, in order to keep our grace from the land to the land. But the life of the land is held to those who are in the distance, living water contamination. And this was a test that never had any ramifications from the present. There's nothing in there about what we do in a hypothetical scenario, and what do we do? It's just the way it's going to be. So, I will leave you with one final sci-fi point. The world where science and where time travel cannot exist, never does.